Hello, it's me again, I'm Nafid. Today we'll talk about Ubuntu installation of Tomcat. So Tomcat 10 on Ubuntu 22, version 22. In here we're going to talk about how to update the packages, install Java as a prerequisite, then install the Tomcat with all details, and then test the installation, making sure it works in this case. Let's have a look. Install update on Ubuntu. So do apt update, sudo apt upgrade minus y means go ahead. That will fetch all the updates and then we'll push the upgrade dynamically because minus y means yes. Okay, and then okay here. Now we're getting ready to install Tomcat 10. After the update, we need to install Java. So open So Java now is installed. Let's double check the version of that Java. Your installation might be different because that's a version at the time of this installation. We're going to create a new user, so then Tomcat can run under that user privilege rather than running it under the root user, because that's a security concern. So we're going to add a user in this case. We're going to create a home directory for the Tomcat user, and that will be under the opt. So we're going to do so. I'm going to create a directory here. We're going to call it Tomcat. We use the, of course, sudo command. And if we use ll and then Tomcat is a directory, we're going to use it when we create the user and we make it home directory for that Tomcat user. So that's the command we're going to issue. Now the user has been created. We can verify the Tomcat has been created using the cat command in the password file. And then using the grep command to filter. Otherwise, we're going to see all users. See, this is the Tomcat user. And that is the home directory for that Tomcat user. And there we go. We will download the Tomcat using the wget to a temp folder, and then we will extract it. We'll download it as a zip file, basically. The binary folder, remember we had two folders here. Go to parents folder. One is the source, one the binary. We need to go to the binary in this case, and we need to download the Tomcat. So basically the link will be this, then appended with this. Using wget, we have this, which is up to the binary folder. And then we're gonna just highlight this and copy this. So this is the zip file here. I'm gonna copy this. Paste it here. And then we're gonna specify the destination folder as a temp. Now it did this. We're gonna unzip this specific file. So we're gonna use the tar command And that's a file we would like. This is the one. And the destination for this will be we can see the Apache Tomcat here. We'll create symbolic link for updates, so make it easy to reference that. So we're going to create symbolic link. And we're going to call that symbolic link latest. Now we're going to change the access of the system user Tomcat to the folder. So we're going to use the change owner. And the shell script, we would like to move to make it executable inside the Tomcat, the binary directory. We'd like to make it executable, basically. So issue this command in this case. Instead of directly executing the shell script for the Tomcat, we would like to run it through a systemd daemon unit file. This means that Tomcat can be run as a service. So what we're going to do, we're going to create a service file, and then we will add some stuff in it, and then we're going to start Tomcat. So we're going to create a file called Tomcat service. I leave all that text in the comment section. So we're going to save this, then we're going to exit. So I'm going to save it, exit. I'm going to reload the daemon. So sudo system control. And we're going to start Tomcat now. So Tomcat service has started. We're going to look at the status of the Tomcat service. It is up and running. So it goes without saying, we can start and stop the Tomcat service. So through the system control command. We can start again, and we can restart if you would like again, just showing you a few possibilities. And again, we can look at the status of the Tomcat. It is up and running. By default, the servlet, the Tomcat, will listen to port TCP 8080. So if you have a firewall blocking this, you might want to make sure that the firewall allow 8080. So this is only necessary if you are listening to this one outside your local LAN. Then you are opening the rule to allow this to into this Tomcat. Just make sure that we understand the IP address of this is 192.168.1.199. So if we go to that IP, that should show us the Tomcat default interface. That's now the Tomcat default interface. That's the IP address for the port 8080 default interface for Tomcat version 10, obviously. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe below to support me and my channel. And I'll see you in future videos. Thank you.